Ubisoft is secretly preparing a pretty big step, according to new rumors. Square Enix announced a new live stream, and we already kinda know what we can expect thanks to new leaks, and Bethesda games are mostly going to be exclusive to Microsoft, although not all of them. And there's way more big gaming news that you should know about, and that I want to go over here in this new Sunday Your Game show. I'm kinda trying a little different format here, going over multiple topics to keep you up to date, making some predictions of course as well, and of course answering one of your questions at the end of the video. If you like that, then a like on the video would really help me out. And let's go. I'm doing a giveaway for any 2021 game of your choice. And if you want to participate, then you can enter via the link in the pinned comments. And these giveaways are for subscribers of the channel only. Good luck. Ubisoft is kind of quiet right now. We know that they have two big games coming soon, like Far Cry 6 and Rainbow Six Quarantine should launch before October this year. So you would think that a Ubisoft 4, to where they kind of re-announce these games, because Rainbow Six Quarantine will, for example, have a different name. Like, doing that in April would make a ton of sense. You can then combine it with maybe a trailer for the Valhalla Druids DLC that I expect to launch around that time too. Roller Champions has a beta going on right now and should also release pretty soon. So combine that all and then you got a pretty big show already. So I totally see that happen in the near future. Maybe throw Prince of Persia in there too with hopefully a better looking trailer. But yeah, right now Ubisoft is more banking on DLC for their 2020 games. We actually learned that the pretty cool looking Myths of the Eastern Realm DLC for Immortals will be launching on March 25th. New character, Chinese mythology. It looks pretty good. But yeah, not a lot of people have played Immortals, which is a shame because this game from the Odyssey creators is awesome, but it was kind of to be expected. Like back in October 2020, I made a video talking about how Ubisoft was killing their own games by releasing them so close to each other. I really think that if Immortals released this month instead, way more people would have given it a shot and actually talked about it. Same for Watch Dogs Legion, totally like the worst of the three in my opinion. But yeah, still, launching the game 2 weeks before Valhalla did not really do it justice. And now the multiplayer is out and just not a lot of people care. I know it's been having some serious connection issues as well, especially on the older consoles. So yeah, you can basically say that apart from Valhalla, and okay, Just Dance as well, Ubisoft games did not do that well. So it makes sense that they are looking at new ways to get people interested. And well, seems like Game Pass is going to be a big part of this. We namely got so-called Xbox Insider special ad saying that a lot of Ubisoft games are coming to Game Pass by the end of the year. And he was actually the first to note that Final Fantasy VII Remake would be coming to PS Plus in March. And then later, in a more cryptic tweet, he hints at Watch Dogs coming to Game Pass. Game Pass Legion is what you can easily see here. And maybe it's also no coincidence that Phil Spencer had the collector's edition statue from Watch Dogs Legion behind him in a recent video, as King Ragnar points out on Twitter, and Phil usually like hides things in his background. So many things are pointing in this direction, and it also makes a ton of sense. Like, get some money for putting your game on Game Pass and see the amount of players who are actually playing your game increase, that then are maybe willing to spend extra on DLC. Money that Ubisoft would have never gotten if it wasn't for Game Pass. And the same could help Immortals. Like, I'm sure people will try it on Game Pass and then maybe get the Season Pass later. I would even argue that it might be smart to spin off the Watch Dogs Legion multiplayer, just like they did with Red Dead Redemption Online, or make it completely free to play so more people can try it. I at least am having a great time. I hope that they fix the many issues that people are having. But right now, it really seems like no hype at all for this pretty big, like, mode that Ubisoft spent a ton of money on. So that's really why I think that Ubisoft is going to focus on making sure that the barrier to entry for their games is going to be as low as possible through Game Pass and Ubisoft Plus, so more people are playing and hopefully spending money on extra content. And that's also where their big free-to-play focus is coming from, which we should also start to see in 2021. And speaking of Game Pass, 20 Bethesda games got added to the service. Pretty sweet if you did not play those titles yet. But more interesting is, of course, regarding the whole exclusive situation. Will we be able to play future Bethesda games on PlayStation as well? We do know that games that are already on PlayStation will be supported, like Elder Scrolls Online is of course a big one. Devloop and Ghostwire Tokyo will still be PlayStation and PC exclusive for 1 year, but then Phil Spencer says this.
And even in the future, there might be things that have either contractual things or legacy on different platforms that we'll go do. But if we're an Xbox customer, the thing I want you to know is this is about delivering great exclusive games for you that ship on platforms where Game Pass exists.
Okay, so two things. It seems that most games will be exclusive, immediately available on Game Pass across all platforms. What if Sony allows Game Pass on PlayStation? Then we get to play those games too, right? No, but I see how people are like kind of running away with the idea that everything will be exclusive. But with Phil also in the short segment talking about the following, and VGC wrote it out, and even in the future, there might be things that have either contractual things or legacy on different platforms that we will go do. I mean, Elder Scrolls and Fallout have a legacy on PlayStation, just like Doom and Wolfenstein. So will these games be coming then? I still find it very vague. And what if Sony already had a Starfield deal before the Xbox buyout? Rumors actually did suggest this. I mean, and with Devloop and Ghostwire Tokyo being PlayStation exclusives, it's not out of the realm of possibility. So Starfield then has to come to PlayStation. There are still many questions, but Phil's statement totally like left the door open for things. So my takeaway is that the big RPGs from Bethesda Game Studios are still coming to PlayStation, but titles from other teams like Arkane will be exclusive in the future. Short term though, PlayStation users get the most awesome upcoming Bethesda game in Devloop, where Xbox gamers have to wait another year. In the meantime, over in Sony's camp, we got Naughty Dog hiring for an economy designer for a multiplayer game with live service elements. This likely has to do with The Last of Us Part 2 multiplayer, right? That could totally be like a sort of PlayStation Plus standalone game at this point. The gameplay in Part 2 was my favorite part actually about that game, so I'm really looking forward to this multiplayer, but this also makes me think that it's kind of still far away with them still looking for someone to work on it. Can we please have a 60fps PS5 patch in the meantime, Naughty Dog? A game that will get a PlayStation 5 patch on March 18th is Marvel's Avengers. It will also come with way more content, including Hawkeye, but we will also already learn what comes beyond that point during a new Square Enix presentation that is also happening on March 18th. The headline will be a new Life is Strange game that was actually already leaked a while back. Bing on Reset Era was actually able to show to the mods on that forum that he was legit. So this person notes that it's being developed by Deck 9, who also worked on Before the Storm, and how it might be called True Colors because the main character Alex is able to read the minds of other characters with colors representing their emotions. That's kind of the synopsis of what is noted here. We should also get a Switch port for Life is Strange 1, and I really liked Part 1, liked Before the Storm as well, never played Life is Strange 2. But I'm totally open and curious what this will be about. We should also expect a new Outriders trailer, a 25th anniversary Tomb Raider announcement, which is very likely going to be the collection that was already leaked of the 2013 reboot, Rise of the Tomb Raider and Shadow of the Tomb Raider, and some other things that you see right here in this image. And I might be live reacting to this, so keep an eye out for that. Like, first day should be pretty exciting, also likely with a new Valhalla Festival. And we actually learned that on Wednesday, so the day before, we get a developer update on Dying Light 2. We haven't seen anything in over a year from this game, so I'm really curious what they will announce, hopefully the release date. Although, like, developer update, it doesn't sound that exciting, so I'm tempering my expectations. And overall, I'm kind of curious what you think of this new Sunday Your Game Show format, because it was first kind of all over the place. I would like think of a topic to discuss every week, but I get that you might like idea one, but not idea two. But I want you to kind of tune in to this Sunday Your Game Show every week, that you kind of know what to expect. So that's why I wanted to discuss the biggest gaming news that I think you will enjoy. That's like kind of suits the channel. So no Nintendo talk about live service games, not only the games that I would discuss here on the channel in one big video, multiple topics. But I'm curious, like, what did you think of this idea? Do you want to see anything changed? All ear, like, I want this to be improved. I want this to be like kind of a returning thing, so you know, okay, every Sunday I can get up to date on the biggest gaming news that I care about here on the channel. Like, that's my kind of goal here. So drop down your input in the comments down below. And of course, in the comments down below, that's not changing, you can leave a question that I might answer in the next Sunday video. And recently I got a question from Sirius, who's also a member of the channel, so thanks for that. When it comes to online events, E3 or Ubisoft Forward, do you expect any big reveals this year, any surprises? And we're kind of getting into that season again, now with Square Enix, Bandai Namco might do their own show to properly re-reveal Elden Ring, Microsoft maybe has a show for the end of the month, those are the rumors. And I again think that Ubisoft might do a Ubisoft Forward in April. So I really think like those will be nice, but the big shows will be in the summer, right, around E3. Sony, for example, 6 months after the PS4 came out, so during their E3 show, unveiled Uncharted 4 that would then launch 2 years later. And we're really at the start of a new console generation where you want to get people hyped up, you want to push people to buy your console already with the promise of big games coming later. And now that the PS5 is out and the Series X, they can talk about these next-gen only games. So I totally expect to see some really big bangers this year that are like still pretty far away in terms of release, but also updates on like Fable from Microsoft, really curious about that. The new God of War will likely get a gameplay trailer this summer. I expect Days Gone 2 to be announced, for example. Hopefully Jedi Fallen Order 2 would make a lot of sense as well. But in terms of like big surprises, I think Bloodborne 2 would be a huge win for Sony. What if that is the game that From Software is working on after Elden Ring, that Sony is going to them with a big wallet of cash? I mean, that would be huge, right? If they can make that happen. What is Kojima doing? Like, he's been quiet for a while. It's not really him to be that quiet. Guerrilla still has this second game. I'm really curious about that. Will Splinter Cell come back? I totally think this generation might be the time for Sam Fisher to shine again. I can still see that be a PlayStation console exclusive. Either way, the point is the gaming industry is bigger than ever right now. And at one point you will be able to buy a PS5 or Series X by just going into a store. So they need to convince you to get the console. And you can only do that with like big reveals. So I totally expect some big ones this year and hopefully some surprises that I now cannot think of. That would be really, really cool. So every Sunday, I want to keep you up to date here on the biggest gaming news that I think you will care about. I will give my impressions, my input, my predictions. So I hope you tune in for the next week's episode. Your feedback is more than welcome in the comments down below. Subscribe to stay up to date on that and way more other content. A like on the video would really help me out. And totally check out my previous Sunday video on single player games that are actually bigger than ever. Like, EA admitted that they were wrong about the single player games being dead. So you can watch that by clicking on the screen. For now, I will speak to you next time and goodbye.